How to keep our kids safe while using apps on their tablets or mobile phones. Our kids spend a lot of time on iPads and tablets and their phones, and part of our role as parents is helping guide them and keep a close eye on what they're doing. There are certain settings in a device, whether it's an iPhone or an Android-based phone, such as Samsung, LG, and others, where we can create certain settings for parental control. They call it control. We never do have control, but it's a form of a step we can take to organize their digital apps. So with those settings, you can specify that the apps on this device, so if it's on a family iPad, the apps on this device are for this age group. So they have different tiers. So depending on how old your kids are, you'd specify the age group tier that they're in. So let's say you specify that they're within 6 to 9 years old, or a certain level of what your kids are. What that means is applications in the App Store that are not for their age don't appear in search. Even though their friends tell them about it or they're trying to look for it, it will not appear in search, and that makes it more difficult for them to install. And that brings up the discussion that you can have with them that this is rated at 13 plus, for example. Every application, movie, game, anything that they watch and see or do has a rating. That means there are specialized bodies that study the content. They've been doing this long before the internet. They study any TV show, movie, app, piece of video, and they say that this is appropriate for a certain age. So PG being parental guidance, G, general audience. So there are different ways for doing so. So the next time they have a play date and they're going to watch a movie, do a quick search and you can look at, you know, the rating. The rating not being the stars and how many stars it got, but is it PG-13, as in parental guidance 13, it's not appropriate for a 7-year-old. Another way to play a more active role, although it's a little bit restrictive, is you can restrict the apps being installed on your tablet or your kid's phone. How that works is there's a setting that shows the setting that once you enable, they cannot install anything. The way I've had to do this at home is they were installing more and more and more apps, not within their age group, and the iPad became full of so many apps, consuming a lot more of their time and getting them to move away from other activities to do on the iPad. It could be educational stuff or just other content that I prefer that they watch or do, or other more offline activities. So when that became very, very, very big, what I ended up doing was I ended up cleaning a lot of the apps, so deleting a good portion of the apps and enabling the restrictions. What that means is I cleaned up all of the apps. That means the apps that are there, they're there. Any new apps will need a parent to put in a code to install it. So anytime they want a new app now, at least now in their age group, my kids are a little bit younger now. When they're older, I'm sure that restriction will need to change. But the way it is now is where they say, I'm interested in this app. We have a discussion about the rating, about the content, and what you're going to do with it. Sometimes, depending, I ask them to look at, okay, if you want to get this new app, let's remove one of the existing apps. Which one would you want to remove? And that gets them to think about their apps and what they're using and so on. So that's a restriction aspect that applies. From a content perspective, YouTube being a big video driver on devices, YouTube Premium has been available in the Middle East recently in September 2019. And that means that if you enable it for your family, they don't get to see ads from the live action footage, which is not the animated part that they're used to. Protect them from the ads. You can do offline viewing. Offline viewing, that means when you go to Teta's house and she doesn't have internet or slow internet, they have the content that they need, or it's a long trip. So that aspect as well helps organize and regulate the content that our kids watch. The school generally recommends 30 minutes of watch time across anything digital. That means the TV, the tablets, the phones, 30 minutes the whole day. Super difficult to get there, but you know. I'm working on this at home. These types of restrictions and controls has helped control a little bit more the consumption of content there. And a lot of it has to do with discussions with them on how we're going to use this and why and so on.